This is the Porcelain Symphony sound panel, where you can adjust your Japanese toilet music or sounds to cover up what goes on in the bathroom. This is a typical Chinese squat toilet, which I've gotten used to. And luckily, in Europe and a lot of the world, there's a bidet and a hose. So you can get thoroughly clean, thank goodness, in a hot, sweaty climate, or perhaps if you're a lady and you're menstruating, it's just wonderful. So in the USA, we have quite simple bathrooms, no water. I have a one-bathroom house, and it serves its purpose. I much prefer having a control panel to adjust the air dryer and the whole environment. But who cares about toilets? I mean, it's interesting, but who spends that much time in the bathroom? I mean, some people, they enjoy their time in the bathroom. It just depends on, you know, your style, how much fun you like to have, who's with you in the bathroom. Sometimes it's your own personal photo studio and you're having a great time. You take some really cool shots, you have some rest. But the Japanese onsen bath, they have a lot of specific rules. No tattoos. Oftentimes you'll be taking a hike and there will be a public hot spring and you can pay for access, but you have to take a pre-shower. You definitely have to shower before you submerge yourself in the shared public bath. This is the bath that was available at the hotel I stayed at near Mount Fuji in Japan. It was a beautiful, wonderful experience, hot springs. There was a lovely lounge area for after bath. The Japanese have definitely taken the art of bathing to a different level. They have these beautiful soaking tubs that they're known for. One of my favorites is Şembarlitos in Istanbul, a 500-year-old bathhouse built by Romans. I went with my friend Aisha, and it was our first time being naked together, and we took a bunch of selfies in the bathroom for obvious reasons. You can't take pictures in the spa, but this is what the place looks like inside. It was beautiful. We got scrubbed and soaked and just felt squeaky clean. People often take a weekly bath. My Moroccan friend is used to having this sort of bath in Morocco. You're often scrubbed by another person, like an experienced woman will do this for you. It's pretty much a woman party, spa day, literally. You hang out with your friends. Not everyone loves spa day. Sometimes it's just an at-home relaxation, soak in the tub. Sometimes you're traveling and you need to take a shower because you're at an airport or you're near a train station. And there is an hourly hotel, but some places have an hourly shower. 15 euros will get you this shower in Schiphol Airport. In a lot of Asian train station areas, they have these available. Sometimes people just bear it. You know, they like to be dirty. They'll tolerate what they have to for cleaning. Even at a cheaper hotel in Japan, they have a beautiful soaking tub and they offer all sorts of bath amenities. This was the one that I stayed at in Tokyo, and I loved the bath. I used it every day. A lot of European and, you know, international hotels have a shower and a bath. This was the Burj Al Arab, and we got a tour of all the bathrooms, all the showers, and of course there was a gold-plated shower, which I had to share. But I think it's important to remember just to enjoy yourself, even if you're in a Burger King bathroom. Take it easy, have fun.